Allah Yahweh, Hashem Yahusha, Hashem Rakam Kadash, the bonus to the apostles, that was a great millstone, peace and blessings and salutations, and to the sincere Hakim, that's our labor, all right, amongst the four corners of the globe, all right, this is 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 4, I'm going to start at the third verse, 2 Timothy 2, 3, therefore, thou therefore endure hardness, as a good soldier of Yahusha Mashiach. Okay? Endure hardness as a good soldier, man. Alright? We are called into this truth, man. We are to become soldiers, man. You know, men, man. You know what I'm saying? Yahusha, Yahusha, man. Alright? And pretty much, man, we're going to be put through the trial, put through the test, man. We're going to see what kind of man we are, man. Are we actually applying the word, man? Are we actually following the ways, man? We are about to be on. Combat out on the battlefield, okay, in combat, your mind, you know what I'm saying, naturally would be to take your enemy out, man. Watch your back, you know what I'm saying? Watch for your fellow soldiers, man, your comrades, man. You know what I'm saying? Making sure that you got your sword ready, man. Alright? If your mind is not focused on that, and your mind is focused on your family back at home, your woman back at home, you know what I'm saying, your kids, man, you know, your worldly possessions, okay? If your mind is focused on those things, you know, while you're in the midst of combat, then your head is going to be slashed off, man. You know what I'm saying? You ain't going to make it, man, because you're so worried about what you got going on in the world. You know what I'm saying? So this same thing applies to being in this truth. All right, we're in a spiritual war, man. You know, the scripture says Satan is seeking whom he may devour, man. You know, and you know, also in Ephesians, the sixth chapter, you know, it goes into having it, putting on that whole armor, man. You know, we got to be girded about, you know, with the armor, man, being this word, wisdom, and knowledge, and understanding of the Heavenly Father, man. All right, and you know, our mind should be occupied in this word, okay. It said, no man that warreth entangle himself with the affairs of this life. Alright? That he may please him who had chosen him to be a soldier, man. Okay? And, you know, a lot of times, man, you know, we get so caught up, you know, where you can get so caught up in what's going on, man, and, you know, in your life, you know, trying to, you know, maintain certain things, okay? You know, worried about, you know what I'm saying, your job, your woman, you know what I'm saying, or, you know, family, man, you know what I'm saying, you're trying to, you know, get caught up in trying to tend to those things, man, and keep, you know, keep things together, man, and, you know, your mind, you'll become distracted, all right, you know what I'm saying, you'll become distracted, man, and those things, you know, could potentially throw you off from serving the Lord, man, or, you know, throw you off from being more focused and you know, this word, man. You know what I'm saying? And that's something that you don't want, okay? All right? It says, 2 Timothy 2 and 4, no man that warreth entangle himself with the affairs of this life. All right? So, you know, pretty much, man, got to be in his spirit, just, you know, for lack of a better word, man, you just gotta be in that fucking spirit, man. You know what I'm saying? And to say this, man, for Jake, I don't want Jake to take it the wrong way and just had it, just, you know, go off, and that means, you know, to have a mind to think that, that just means to go around and just say, fuck it, I'ma just be in a, just go off an impulse and, just go how I'm feeling, man, and just say, you know what I mean? I do some foolish, make foolish choices. That's not what I mean, man. But what I mean is, you know, now you gotta be willing to forsake all, man. All right, get rid of whatever it is that you find unto yourself to be a distraction to you, man. You know, or if a brother come to you and say, man, brother, you know, I don't know what's going on, man, or whatever, but you ain't been, you know, you're not focused, man. You know what I'm saying? All right? You're not getting into the shows as how you once was, man. You're not linking up with brothers as much as you was, man. All right? You on the block, you know what I'm saying? And it's almost as if, you know, you're not sharp, man. You know, you slow to react. You're not really paying attention, man. What the fuck? You know what I'm saying? So if a brother come to you, you got to examine yourself and take heed. You know what I'm saying? Yo, all right? Check yourself, man. All right? Whatever it is that your mind is dwelling on, shake that shit off, man. Or if it's something that's hindering you from doing the work, you got to get rid of it, man. All right? You know? 2 Timothy 2:4, no man that war entangle himself with the affairs of this life, that he may please him who had chosen him to be a soldier. All right? And that was pretty much the point, man. You know, we got to remain focused on this word, man. All right? Remaining focused and diligent and examining, you know, ourselves. All right? You know what I'm saying? And taking heed to the times, man, because, you know, we're in pretty much damn near at the end, man. All right? You know, we're getting closer, all right? And, you know, hey, you know, we got to remain steadfast in this word, man, you know, and focus, all right? So I hope that was edifying, you know. With that, all praise is going and honor to Yahweh, Bahashim, Yahweh Shah, the honors to the apostles, the elders of Great Millstone, peace and blessings and salutations to the sincere Hakim. With that, Shalom.